Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection because perfection doesn't exist.
Right, I'm looking at the footage of this video and just so you know, I'm trying out Verst, their new mineral sunscreen. And it looks so bad. My skin looks so white in this video. It's making my eyes look like bloodshot. I'm not a fan. I thought it sat okay on my skin, but I came away from this, saw the footage, it was peeling off my skin, so I don't recommend it, but also please ignore the white cast in this video and probably my next one.
Today I'm going to do a hits and shits video. This is a video where I share some of my favourites and not so favourites throughout the last month. I don't do them every month, maybe I should, but this is actually for February. I'm a little bit late with this. But I want to share some skincare, hair care, even some body care here that I've absolutely loved throughout February and will be using going into March. And please remember that none of these products are shit. It's just like a catchy title, you know, hits and shits because it rhymes. And just because I don't like a product and it didn't work for me, it doesn't mean that it's not going to work for you. So if you like the look of the product, by all means, test it out. Let me know if you liked it or not. Let's start off with a hit. This is body care and it's a little bit grabby because I use this like daily and it's right next to my shower. This is the Kapari Coconut Spritz Mist. This is a hydrating body spray. So I can be really lazy when it comes to body care. I am extremely lazy when it comes to body care. I'll shower. I'm really fussy about my body washes, like my body cleansers, which we'll talk about in a bit. When I'm out the shower, I'm cold. I'm just gonna quickly dry myself down. I'll sometimes do like a quick moisturizer on my like elbows and my kneecaps. And then I'm like, oh, I'm bored. This is too much effort. It's a lot of effort to moisturize your whole body, right? But also rubbing in body cream when you have hairy legs is really difficult. You really have to work on it. So this, I saw this and I was like, oh, a mist might be better because I used to use those Vaseline body mist ones, but I didn't like the smells of them. But this is a really nice body mist in the sense that you can mist it all over. You just really quickly rub it in. To be honest with you, I apply this onto damp skin, kind of like let myself air dry a little bit, give this a chance to work into the skin, usually do my skincare, and then I just dry myself down with a towel. And I very rarely have to rub this in. It's so light. It's so light. It mists out so well. It's just airy and light on the skin, but super hydrating and moisturizing as well. So this has niacinamide in, as well as vitamin B5, which is a humectant, so it pulls in that hydration. We have sugar-derived squalane in here as well, so nicely moisturizing without being greasy. And we also have coconut milk, not coconut oil, coconut milk, which helps protect your skin. It might have coconut oil in, but the main thing they stress is the coconut milk, again, to help protect your skin. This is, and also we have aloe as well, which is nicely soothing. We also have vitamins, minerals, enzymes, and amino acids. So it's really, really nourishing for the skin. But what I like about this the most is I'm not one of those people that really likes coconut, the smell of coconut. Like Palmer's like really upsets me. It's too coconutty. It's too sweet, I think. This has like a hint of coconut, with it mixed with like a floral kind of scent, which coconut and floral scents I usually hate, but for some reason this isn't too sweet, it's not too floral, they both kind of counteract each other and just gives you a really nice, slightly sweet, fresh scent on the skin. So yeah, I've actually avoided Kapari for a long time because they are mainly coconut products. In fact, I think all of them are coconut products, but this is the first thing I tried. I'm glad I did because I kind of realized it's not that sweet coconutty scent that I'm used to. Some of their products are, but it's bearable. I can see this being really nice in summer where when you want to moisturize but you don't want to feel like all sticky and too heavy covered in anything. It's super lightweight. I really love it. I've been using it for about 2 months non-stop now. This actually sits in my shower and then I spritz myself in the shower because it's a little bit like you spray and then sometimes you miss your body and you don't want it going everywhere, so it just kind of like hits my shower glass instead. But a little bit goes a long way with this. It's very light, but the lightness does the job it needs to do. On a similar note, I bought this with my own money and I also bought this with my own money. Kapari have recently sent me stuff, but none of them are featuring today's video. This is the Kapari Ultra Restore Body Butter with Hyaluronic Acid. I don't like body butters. I don't like body butter, shea butter, coconut oil. It just, but the word body butter to me kind of reminds me of those really heavy, overly scented like body shop products. You know, I don't want to smell like a 14-year-old. Do you know what I mean? Like, they're just not for me. But I saw this on at the Dirty Boy Gets Clean Instagram. Instagram. Literally, his profile has made me buy so many things. A lot of them feature in today's video. Anything pink that I use from now on is usually inspired by his Instagram page. You should definitely check it out. He did a sponsored post with Kapari and it just looked so nice. And then it led me to even more reviews. And this is basically a body butter without that thick moisturizing feeling. It still moisturizes, but because it's more hydrating, it feels so much lighter on the skin. To look at, it still looks pretty thick. Oh, sorry, I've been like digging in like this. It still looks pretty thick, but really it's just, it's like creamy water when it hits the skin. It rubs in so quick as well. They have coconut milk and coconut husk in here. It sounds like they use the whole coconut. They don't waste anything. They say on the website that it's got a delightful, lighter than air whipped formula. And I agree. I think a lot of people using that term whipped to kind of like emphasize how light their products are, but it's a good description. We do have hyaluronic acid in here, of course, for hydration as well as glycerin. We do have coconut oil in here, which is a heavy fatty acid rich oil, but you don't feel that. You don't feel like slimy after. We have mango seed oil, soybean oil, which is so nice for moisturizing. We also have antioxidants in the form of beetle abs bark extract. Did autocorrect change that? I don't know. Basically, it's an antioxidant that helps to improve barrier function. This is just really, really nice. And this kind of passes the rubbing into hairy legs test in the sense that, like, I don't have to spend ages rubbing it through. So it encourages me to moisturize after I shower. And again, we have that coconutty scent, but when it hits your skin and slides over like slightly damp skin, it's like completely diluted. You get a hint of it every so often, but it's not overpowering and you're not sniffing it throughout the day. Well, my dog's kind of like always try and lick my arms after, but I can't smell it after. And I just love the packaging. It looks so good in my bathroom. Right, let's talk about shit because I'm kind of disappointed. I'm not disappointed. This is the Paula's Choice Hyaluronic Acid and Peptide Lip Booster. This is absolutely fine. It feels really nice on the lips. It's long lasting. Once you apply it once, you don't find yourself like then licking your lips half hour later or constantly feeling the need to reapply because it's not quite doing what it needs to do, like other lip balms. It's not sticky. It's not got a shiny finish. I did use this for a solid month as my only lip balm because I kind of had no choice. And while I will say I didn't see my lips like plumping out, like the hyaluronic acid didn't really do anything for my lips, it made my lips feel comfortable. They were never chapped, you know? This almost forms like a slight film on your lips in the sense that, like, how do I say? Like, you feel, if your lips feel good, you can put this on in the morning, and I think you can feel fine throughout the day as long as you're not eating and drinking too much, and then, like, reapply at night, and you're absolutely fine. So why do I dislike this so much? Well, I took this on a hen do last year. It was my only lip balm I took with me, and I could just taste it. All weekend, it tastes like pencil sharpenings, like crayons. And that's usually what happens when a product doesn't add in artificial fragrance or fragrance of any kind. You get that kind of like what the original formulation smells and tastes like. You know when you can taste the smell? Well, it's on your lips, so you probably can actually taste this product a little bit. It's something that just kept hitting the back of my throat when I applied it. And it would last as long as the lip balm would on your mouth. So like, this is great in the sense that you apply it in the morning and by mid-afternoon, you probably might not even have to apply it again. But for as long as it's on your lips, you can taste it. And if I was like breathing in to laugh or taking a breath to talk or whatever, it would catch in the back of my throat and make me cough. And you don't want to be coughing because of lip balm and people mistaking you for being sick, especially nowadays, you know? I can't tell if it's a shea butter or a certain oil in here that's doing it, but that's what it tastes like. It tastes like very oily, shea buttery. It's on brand for Paula's Choice, and I know this isn't their thing, but this is where I appreciate a very subtle fragrance within lip balms or flavoring. I'm pretty sure lip balms do have flavoring in, but like a very subtle strawberry or what's more their kind of thing. I don't know, like a very, very subtle vanilla, something just to knock out that kind of like kind of feeling. I don't know if that's how it works. Would fragrance do that? I don't know. Something to counteract that, then this would be probably one of the best lip balms I've ever used. I honestly think it won't bother a lot of people. But for me, it's got squalane in as well. I wish I could use it, but I don't want to be coughing and choking on it all the time. Oh, okay, let's talk about a body wash. Again, this is in my shower, so it's a little bit grubby, but this is the Solterre, in particular, their Black Tide Skin Hydrating Serum Body Wash. I actually saw this all over Instagram. They did very well with their paid promotion. I think it wasn't like influencer paid promotion, it was just adverts. Or did it show up? I don't know. I saw it on Instagram and I needed them. But I bought all their body washes, because the packaging sells it for me. It looks good, and I know they have good products. And also, Sean Garrett over on Twitter, esthetician, likes these products too, so you know they're good. He has very good taste in skincare and fragrance, and I think when you merge the two together, like we'll talk about the fragrances in this in a minute, if he approves it, you know it's good, you know? So I bought these all myself, but they have sent me a few as well. This one, and they sent me an orange one and a green one, but I bought the full range myself. So first of all, the packaging is amazing. These are made from 100% aluminium. You get like a little screw top. You can see it. You get like a little silver screw top, which you take off and the plastic pump comes separate. 100% aluminium, so they're easy to recycle. And first of all, when they arrive, they have these little dents in. I was like, oh my God, what the fuck? I was like, the packaging's like really damaged. And then they sent out this really cute email about how they love their dents and why that, you know, is gonna happen if you have aluminium packaging, but it's good for the environment. I was like, you know what? Yeah, I can deal with a few dents, like if it means we can recycle them. And they still look amazing. They still look so good. Ingredient wise, in this particular one, I think, you know, they have a few standard ingredients throughout all their body washes, but in this particular one, they have hyaluronic acid, of course, for hydration, microalgae to help balance out the skin, plant-derived squalane, and a Brazil nut to hydrate. They also have niacinamide, licorice root, and the fragrance in here. Whilst they do a fragrance-free body wash, I like fragrance in my body wash. It makes me feel cleaner. I don't know why. It just makes me feel like I've cleansed. This smells like a successful, serious person. It smells like it's verging on manly musk without being too masculine for my tastes. It's woody. It's smoky. It's like a little bit mysterious, but really refreshing at the same time. It's like, it just smells like a successful person. Honestly, it smells like all the successful women I've ever met who are like, I've always inspired to like be on their level of success. It reminds me of that kind of like clean, yet with a hint of something. And you're like, is that just how they smell? Are they that amazing? That's what it smells like. If you've never heard me talk about Forever Mood candles before, the scents in these remind me of that, because Forever Mood candles make smells that I feel like I've never smelt before, and they also bring back memories that I'm not even sure are real, but their smells put me and transport me into such a specific situation, specific time that probably didn't even exist, but this is what their scents do. You smell this and you're like, oh my God, like I know this smell, like why do I know this? But also you don't. You can't quite pinpoint what it is. I don't know if that makes sense. I don't know. But I love these. I can't wait to finish this one and open up all the others. The texture of this as well is like, you know, like some body washes can be a little bit too liquidy. This has almost like a, how do I describe it? Like a thick gel texture to it. So like you can put it in your hands and do that. It's not going to fall out all over your arms and plop into the shower. You can lather it up easily in a like little, what are they called? Scrubby thing, if that's what you use. I just really enjoy using them. I love everything in a pump bottle as well. It's so much easier to use. Maybe not in the shower. Sometimes in the shower, it's just easier to do that and squeeze. Because in this, I'm like, you know, oh, no. But yeah, love those. The next shit is Neogen's Cica Repair Snail Cream. Speaking of smells, I did not like the smell of this at all. We aren't anti-fragrance here, but we are very anti-fragrance being the main point of the product. Their fragrance taking over your entire face. I was originally interested in this because I love Neogen as a brand. A lot of their products have been very big hits for me. And I love restorative, repairing moisturizers, especially snail secretion. It's just something that has always worked for my skin. This one in particular contains niacinamide, madicassicide, cica complex, you know, all the stuff that you find in restorative, repairing moisturizers. These calming, gentle, repairing creams. The texture of this is actually perfect. It's so lightweight. It's super hydrating. Great for oily skin. Think the COSRX Snail Mucin Moisturizer, but not as gloopy. It's more of a watery texture. I personally love the gloopiness of the COSRX one and prefer that over this. The issue here for me is that for a restorative cream, this broke me out like crazy. I had such a bad rosacea flare up. And honestly, I can use a fair bit of fragrance without it bothering my rosacea at all. But I do put the rosacea down to this, maybe the fragrance, because it's just, I don't even know what that is. It flared me up so bad. I was so spotty, and I was getting comments on my videos of people being like, oh, your nose is really red, your cheeks are red. First of all, that's fucking rude. You know I have rosacea. But once I stopped using it, after a few days, you can see it really calming down, like really, really calming down. But this would give me those pinpoint itchy, like breakouts where I just wanted to put my fingernail in it, like really scratch at it, because they were itchy and painful. And the smell just doesn't make sense. It's like, I don't even know how to describe it. It's like sugar-coated petals with some kind of fruit. I don't know. Why does it have to smell like that? I don't know. It's just a smell that would linger. It would just linger. Actually, I remember like the second day I used it, I didn't put it on my nose. I literally kind of like just did this in hopes that I wouldn't smell it like all day, because this clings to your face. It's really just not nice. Oh, the next hit is the Kira Moon, I think I said that right, Silky Rinse Ceramides and Rosewater Gentle Hydrating Facial Cleanser. This is another one that I bought because of the packaging. It's a brand that I've seen on Instagram for the longest time. I've been meaning to get it over and over and over, but it's not available in the UK, so I had to use my American address, and that takes time. If you want to know how I get American only products, I use a shipping service called Ship It To, which to begin with I thought was a scam. I was like, oh, am I just like sending them money? But they give you an American address which you send stuff to, then they ship it over to you in the UK. It can get pricey, so I usually wait till my brother orders something, or I get a load of stuff together, so then you kind of pay the customs all in one go. But as well as seeing this brand all over Instagram, and just liking the packaging and the general aesthetic, I've heard nothing but good reviews, to the point where I was like looking at these posts and I was like, are they sponsoring these people? And they weren't sponsored posts. They were just genuinely praising this brand and their products. And I see why. This is a non-stripping cleanser, but it really is a non-stripping cleanser. You put this on, it still lightly foams, which I kind of like, but that foam is still kind of like jelly and gloopy. So you're just gliding this over your face, you rinse it away, and your skin is left feeling soft, not dry, not tight, really soft. It actually works great at removing layers of sunscreen as well. I have a UV camera mirror, which I use to kind of like just make sure I'm applying sunscreen everywhere and taking it off everywhere. I've just been testing like a few cleansing balms and techniques and stuff. And this removes, this is a great first and second cleanse. And it smells so good. It's like fruity, like almost melony, but not like American artificial melon, more like honeysuckle, you know, like really watery melon. The key ingredients in here are ceramides, which of course help strengthen your skin barrier and restore the barrier as well. We have squalane in here, and you can feel that lightweight moisturizing kind of like feeling without greasiness or oiliness. Rose water, and we also have raspberry extract, which is an antioxidant, but you also have aloe leaf juice in here, which is nicely soothing, along with cucumber extract. And I think that you can kind of smell that along with the fruitiness, which adds this freshness rather than sweetness to it. This is currently my everyday cleanser. I'm nearly out of it. I'm going to buy it again and again and again. I absolutely love this. Oh, also, okay. So when I first got this, I was like, oh, this is cute. And I was like trying to twist the lid. I was like, oh, you know, it's a bit annoying that I have to do this like every time I want to use a cleanser. But literally this top bit just screws off. That's so obvious. I don't know why I didn't get it. You won't do that because you're not a fucking idiot like I am. But yeah, I love this. I've also got their hydrating serum, which I'm loving just as like a general hydrating serum. I got their exfoliating, I can't remember now. Like, I think it's like an exfoliating treatment, and their ice globes as well, which I really, really love. Oh, we'll really quickly talk about this shit because it's not even worth talking about. This is the Bellflower Watermelon Fresh Sunscreen SPF 50 Plus PA 4 Pluses. This is a perfect example of a typical chemical sunscreen that no one likes. It stinks of alcohol. Like, it's got a really artificial, like, board pen smell to it. It broke me out. It stung my eyes. It flared up my rosacea. Like, my face was hot. This is so bad. I was like, well, you know, I'd rather not just wear sunscreen if this is gonna be the case. I've used it twice, and it honestly, it just stung. It broke me out, like little tiny spots on my forehead. It's just everything you hate in a chemical sunscreen is in this sunscreen. It also says watermelon, and it doesn't even smell like watermelon. It's just pink. I want to end on two hits because there's so much I've been loving, and I am in love with this brand and this product. This is the Astura Atto Barrier 365 Cream. I'm not sure why it's limited edition, because you can buy it and it, without that limited edition bit on. I don't know, maybe the size, I don't know. This is my CeraVe. This is it for me. Not only do I use this when my skin has gone to shit, but I use this every night as my nightly moisturizer. Not because it's heavy or greasy, just in the morning I'm usually testing new moisturizers or, you know, testing something else. This is basically a skin barrier strengthening cream that also comes in the form of a lotion. They have a toner, they have an essence. What else do they have? They have a cleanser, all in this line. So whilst the main function of this is barrier repair, I often associate barrier repair products with being quite heavy and greasy, but all their products have been a pleasure to use. I mean, their main demographic is people with damaged and really dry skin, but as someone with oily skin, I don't find this too heavy. Like, I'm not sure why it's just targeted to people with dry skin. You know, even when you do have a damaged skin barrier, you're dehydrated, you can still get oily. So it is difficult sometimes to find a skin barrier repairing product that is light enough for oily skin. And for me, this is it. It ticks all the boxes. We have fatty acids in here, we have ceramides, we have cholesterol, squalane, and you get an amazing moisturized, hydrated feel without any of the greasiness. We also have hydroxypropyl bispalmitate MEA, aka pseudoceramides. This basically mimics what ceramides do in our skin, but to put it very simply, it's easier to formulate with and formulate into skincare. We also have healing and soothing allantoin, and this is good. It just goes beyond being a basic repair cream for me, and I believe this kind of product belongs in everyone's skincare routine. I know I always joke about not liking CeraVe. I honestly think they're a great brand. Their products just aren't for me. For me, their formulations don't, my skin doesn't like them. They're either a bit too heavy or greasy, or some of their products just kind of roll off my skin for some reason. I just find the formulations to be unsatisfactory. And yes, from a product point of view, they do the job they're supposed to do, but we're in a day and age now where products need to go beyond just doing the job that they need to do. This product for me, it looks clean, it looks elegant, it looks modern, and it works amazingly for my skin. Yes, it smells a little bit like PVA glue, it smells a little bit like craft glue, but I can look past that because what it does for my skin is incredible. I have been doing a very basic routine with this, and I've seen such a significant change in my rosacea. I've not been going fragrance free, this is fragrance free, but I've not been going fragrance free. I use a lot of Glow Recipe, which my skin absolutely loves. But what I've been concentrating more is just barrier repair, and this has been key to that. We're gonna leave on a hair product, and this is the Way Leave-In Conditioner. I wasn't sure how to pronounce this. It's not, it's just Way. So I think I've already talked about this. What did I talk about this in? I can't remember, but I got a sample of this from Cult Beauty, like a really tiny one, and I wasn't going to use it. I was just actually going to put it in like my giveaway pile, but I've always wanted a Way candle. So I was like, oh, I'm going to smell this and see if I get a candle that smells like it, if it's any good. And Way candles just always look really, really good. But it smells amazing, amazing. So this is obviously a leave-in conditioner that you're applying to wet hair, brush or scrunch through, and then just leave it. After a shower, I usually shower, if I'm not going anywhere during the day, I will shower in the evening. If I'm going somewhere during the day, I'll shower both, right? Or just once in the morning. But usually in the evening, because I don't go anywhere, I need something to slick my hair back and basically keep it out of the way. Like, it's down to here, so I just need it out of the way. So usually I like to use a leave-in conditioner to keep it slicked back. This didn't do that, but not in a bad way, and I'll tell you why in a minute. But when I first decided to use this, I was like, a spray leave-in conditioner, like, this is gonna spray out clumpy and thick, and I'm just gonna get blobs of it, like, uneven. But this spray is like a mist. Do you see that? I don't know if you can even see it. No, I don't think you can see it. It smells so good. It's like a mist. It's a mist. So it, like, so evenly mists over your hair. Brush it through, and then I do another one, brush that through, and then just leave it. So you get really nice, even coverage. And that's why it's not good for sticking my hair back, because a lot of leave-in conditioners that I've used are like hair masks, in the sense that your hair kind of dries down like you got gel in it. Don't mean like a wet look gel in your hair, and your hair is kind of like clumpy and in bits. But this doesn't do that. This dries out soft in your hair, like you've had a treatment and then a blow dry, and you're left with really fluffy, soft hair. Not frizzy, like there's no strays. It's just really nice and soft to run your hands through. I don't even know what the ingredients are. It's just like a lot of nice oils. But it's really nice in your hair. As I said, it's not greasy, it's not oily. It dries down nice and dry and soft. I love the smell. It's a little bit floral. And again, I keep saying I'm not into florals, but I've not been minding them recently. This smells like your best friend's other best friend. Do you know what I mean? Like, not you, their other best friend who's actually really nice. Or like your best friend's mum who you feel really comfortable around. It's like this comforting, warm floral feeling. Again, slightly musky. I believe you have bergamot in here and rose as well. So it's, I don't know, I really like it. I actually got the fragrance of this, like the standalone fragrance, because I like the smell of it that much. I didn't realize, but this also has heat protectant in, so you can kind of use it as a pre-styler. It says it can protect hair from heat damage up to 450 degrees Fahrenheit, which is 230 degrees centigrade. Why on earth would you ever, why would your hair ever be that hot? That's so weird. I don't know. I couldn't find much about the ingredients either. It's just really, really good. When you use something like this, make sure to towel dry your hair before or squeeze out water from your hair and then leave this in. But yeah, I absolutely love it. I've definitely noticed a difference on the drier ends of my hair. I really love that. So those are my hits and shits for the month of February. Let me know if you've tried any of these. Maybe you hate the ones that I love. Let me know in the comments down below. You can watch some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.